Hi guys, how's it going? So today I am going to do another video, of course, that's why we're here. But first I want to tell you that I do have a website. I announced it on Facebook a few days ago, a week ago, something like that. And I wanted to make a video on here, but that day my internet was not working. I could not get anything to upload. So I'm telling you now. And I'd also like to remind you that I was nominated for a WeGo Health Award, Best in Show of YouTube, of course. That's where I do most of my stuff. So I just want to remind you that if you would like to vote or endorse me, I'll put the link below. That would be really awesome. I'm so excited to be a part of it again. So, all right, let's get into the real purpose of this video. And that is going to be talking to you guys about why I don't empty my bag. That's right, I'm not lying. I don't empty my bag, not normally. people think I'm crazy when I tell them that. They're like, wait a second, what? No, I, a long time ago, had some struggles with drainable pouches and I was looking for something else and I kind of fell into the non-drainable pouches by accident. I was totally against them for forever. They did not make sense to me, but now I use them. And I apologize if you hear Leroy talking to you. My ostomy is going crazy right now and I can't get it to be quiet. So if you hear it, it's just what it is. So typically when somebody gets a brand new ostomy, they start you off with a clear bag, usually the kind that empties, whether it be a Velcro end or a clip or a little nozzle, something along those lines. That's what they start you off with. It kind of goes back and forth whether they start you with a one-piece or a two-piece. I was started off with a one-piece because they tend to be a little bit more flexible, and I was very thin. So where my ostomy was, my stomach kind of jutted inward. But then later on, I was moved to a two-piece. So those bags are not optimal, I would say, for real life. Those bags are great in the hospital when you want to be looking at the stoma constantly to make sure that it's, you know, that beefy red, pink color, make sure that there's output coming out, see the color and the consistency of the output really well. It's all great for that. When you go home and, you know, you're doing well and you don't need to monitor these things as closely, you want something that's like more realistic for you, something that doesn't show your output constantly, like anytime you look at it. I don't know about you guys, I didn't want a clear bag, so when I found out that there were opaque ones, went straight for it. But as for the emptying, I just found like a lot of issues emptying my bag, and you would think, you know, I've had it for a while, so I should be well versed in emptying my ostomy bag, but I just couldn't get a good technique down. I had issues with cleaning the end of the bag. I started with Velcro and I found them to be way too messy. Like even when I help kids in the hospital with the Velcro clips, I hate them. Like I can't get them clean without having a hose to clean the end off. It's just, I just haven't found a good way to clean the end of the bag. The output gets stuck in the Velcro. And it's just not cleanly. I don't know. I just really didn't like it. With the clips, it was a little bit better because it was just the plastic part of the bag. There was no Velcro for stuff to get stuck in. So it's just the plastic of the bag and I could use some water to like rinse it out. But even then, I couldn't get all of the water. I couldn't get it completely dry. So when I clip it up, it would just kind of like spread onto my shirt. It would seep through my shirt. I had a lot of difficulties with that and I just really didn't like it. I also had issues with emptying it, like leaning down over the toilet, trying to aim, which sometimes I would not aim very well, or I would take the clip off prematurely and wind up with a mess. Although I did a review of the ostomy aid, which I wish I had back then because I think that would have helped immensely. I would have had to aim anywhere. But at the time I was just emptying straight into the toilet and like having to lean over, which is not great for post-surgery patients. It's just hard to do. So I hated that. You know, you never know when there's gonna be like splashback and there goes your shirt, like go get a new one on. I used to go through outfits pretty quickly because You never know what's gonna happen while emptying a bag. The other part of it was the clips that I would use were really rigid. So if I was trying to, sorry, Bruno's probably gonna try and knock my camera over. If I would try and conceal the end of my bag, that was the part that you saw. Like, my bag could be pretty full and it would be, you know, you could smooth it out, but it was the clip that just stuck out. It just, I didn't know what to do with it. I tried tucking it into my pants and it just looked awkward. So I didn't like having the closure at the end. It was just too bulky, too hard. There were just too many issues with the drainable pouches, and I wasn't really seeking out a non-drainable. That really never crossed my mind because non-drainable bags didn't make sense to me. I thought, you know, what am I gonna do when I have to empty this thing, when it gets full? Am I gonna have to rip the whole thing off? They do make one piece non-drainables, which still make no sense to me because your skin gets so irritated pulling off a bag all the time. The only time I can think that that makes sense is if you have a colostomy and, you know, your output is so much lower than mine. But with an ileostomy, I'm emptying it, you know, 5 to 7 times a day. It just didn't make sense for me to be messing with my skin that much. I mean, my skin gets so raw. I remember with the Convatec photo shoot that I did and the video shoot, I had to keep changing bags and like pulling them off. My skin was so sore. It was awful. But anyway, back to the point. I wasn't looking for non-drainable pouches. I was looking for another bag that just like had an easier way of doing things. So I was trying a bunch of different brands. I remember this was my sophomore year of college. It was when I started dating Zach, and there's really nothing worked for me. It would either like not stick in the shower, or it's too bulky, or the plastic was too crinkly for me. It was just something. And Hollister, the bags that I used, the drainable ones, were the ones I always went back to. But then summer came around and I was looking for a bag that was just really small that I could just take off and put a new one on really quick for going to the shore, going to the beach. And I had these little tiny square ones that I think connected to Convatec bags, but I was wondering if Hollister made the same thing. And I found these ones that were, you know, not super tiny, but they were smaller than the normal drainable pouches. And I ordered a box and wound up falling in love. And that's just what I've stuck with since that time, years ago. It's been like 5 years, 6 years now. So that's why I wound up using it. It's so sleek. The plastic isn't crinkly on me. There's no clip to bug me. There's no clip that I have to clean, no end of the bag to clean. All I do is take one of the little bags that come with the Hollister pouches. I put it around my bag and just pop it off the flange. And then I'll clean around the ring, you know, where the bag connects, and I'll pop on a new bag. And it's so easy, especially when I'm out in public or out at work. And it's made a world of difference. I'd feel like it's just so much more clean too. So I thought I would share why I don't have a drainable pouch, why I don't empty my ostomy bag. I just throw it away. Because when I tell people that, you know, I don't have a drainable pouch, they look at me like I have two heads. Like, people at work, it kind of clicks with them and they say, Maggie, like, what do you do at work? Like, how do you empty your bag? Just carry a couple spares with me. They fit in your pocket. You fold them up. No problem. Works great. So that is my video for today, guys. I hope that you enjoyed this, and I will be working on more. I'm going to try and go back through my old videos and write corresponding posts for them for my website. And I really hope you like the website. Took me a while. I made it one time and then it got deleted and then I had to redo it. I actually wound up liking it better the second time I made it, but whatevs. Alright guys, I will talk to you soon and post any comments, questions below. Alright, bye!